It is a powerhouse, no doubt about it. It's got to a scale now where people are recognising it as being a viable, sustainable, long-term economy and a long-term growth story, more to the point, with, again, the infrastructure investment coming forward over the next few years.
Attracting a lot of people's attention and also investment from government, particularly for what I would say is the infrastructure projects that need to be invested in. Obviously HS3, HS2 are a few, and Manchester Airport, which I find is a very good airport that people do fly into. We've obviously got good connectivity to the rest of the region.
Actually having Manchester United and Manchester City now is such a great pull, because people worldwide Manchester United fans, and they know where Manchester is because of football.
Investors looking for the next best thing after London to invest into, and predominantly the answer has been Manchester when that question's been asked. So that goes for all sectors: office investment, residential, retail, leisure. You know, every month or so it seems that Manchester's breaking occupancy records.
Manchester in itself is taking at the forefront of that and is driving through growth and business generation, attracting a lot of attention from not only corporate occupiers but investors, global investors.
CoStar said this morning that, was it 48% of the investment in Manchester had come from worldwide places, and a lot of that has come in through the Far East.
More than just having a great Chinatown in the city, it's about having, you know, that Chinese investment foundation in the economy as well. It's going to move a lot of different things forward.
A lot of the fears around the Chinese stock market and hard landing, etc., I actually see as a positive. Rather than invest locally, a lot of people in that market are looking at safer assets, and the value of London perhaps precludes them from investing there, so their next destination is Manchester.
But there's also the rental growth story, which is prevalent in Manchester, as there's been a significant Grade A office supply shortage. There's 216,000 square feet of existing stock currently in the market in Manchester, which is due to be occupied by quarter three, quarter four by next year. So therefore, I think that shortage in itself will help to increase rents, drive rents forward, and also look to kickstart some new, further speculative office development in the city centre.
There is a healthy competition between Birmingham and Manchester. I clearly would say Manchester is the second city. Clearly Birmingham is much closer to London and will potentially, with HS2, become more of a potential dormitory town, whereas Manchester is actually far enough away to actually stand on its own 2 feet, and also coming, linking back to the Northern Powerhouse, it'll actually spread the benefit through the region and across the Pennines.